Okay, here is just a piece of small paper. I still have some leftover color, so trying to use it up. No other purpose in this. A piece of paper. It's a flat surface. It's really not a particular goal, and just to see what will come up. I have some leftover blue color, and put into sink will be quite terrible. It's already messing up the table, so it's better that I just finish this color. I have several blue in it, different tone. And they are not contrasting, so it is okay to put together. Sometimes you put red, green, blue, pink, and the color comes out very bizarre, very dirty, not clean, and it's not a good harmonious blending. But this one looks pretty easygoing. They are all from the same color family. So should be okay. So these are tempera color, and they are not opaque. So you better put a little bit more of it. Some part. Make it smooth. This one. You can create some texture or just go like this. Have some fun here and there. Still I have much too more than I needed. This should be okay for painting on top of it. Maybe create something more interesting here and there. That's the point of making a background, right? You do not want it even out. You want it to be a very mischievous, very different, right? You don't want a piece of a flat paper, right? If it is a flat paper, you can just buy a piece of colored paper. No point to do it like this, right? So it's on the one hand having fun. On the other hand, try something new, and it is one of the most difficult and challenging things to start something anew, don't you think so? Start something from totally new and a piece of plain white paper. So this way can get rid of a little bit of the scale. For those, so you get color on top of it, and then you know that there is already color. You have more chance, opportunity, inspiration, and more triggers for you to get started. A piece of plain white paper is just scary, right? a piece of plain white paper is very, very scary. Here is dirty, I want to cover it up. Okay, I am almost done with my glue. And this job, usually it's better to do by the children. They have fun playing around with color, and also it is good for us. So often time we stuck in having no idea, right? We are always so comfortable in our own comfort zone, in our own production zone, and it's very difficult to do something new and try something different. It's not we do not want to do that, it's just it's not we do not want to do it, we do not be creative. It is hard to break your thinking pattern, your habit pattern. And we just do not have that much ability to think differently. And it's too foreign to us, for us to think totally different, totally challenging ourselves. This can be anything, a stormy sky, a troubled water, or a haunted house, a haunted night background. It can be anything. So create something that you usually do not see. When you buy a piece of perfect clean paper, right? And this is not art. This is having fun. Okay, you go to university, you do not learn this. And okay, let's just do not talk about art or not, since it's not important at all. We live a life. And that's it. And we mess around things and make it as surprise as we can, right? So get some people who never do painting, and get a piece of paper and. Okay, you go ahead, put any color, anything, and let them have fun. It will be breaking up your thinking pattern, and it will force you to think differently, right? This is a starting point. I do not know what it will go to, because the whole purpose is just to use up the paint. It is not clean to put into the sink. And this one also, it's just to create something to use up the paints, right? No big deal. See you later, alligator. I'm going to wash my brush.